Hey guys, so it's here bringing you another video. Welcome back to Iron to Master, the series I take a Smurf account, Fresh account, never played Rent before, and show you the adventure to Diamond. We return Bronze 150 LP. Unfortunately, we had another loss last episode. Completely pointless. Everybody just fed. It was bleh. Kind of had an AFKing Draven in a way, but yeah. Anyway, we're in this game now, and we're playing Camille, and yes, we are against, for the first time for me personally, we're against one of the cheesy support tops. So I actually have not laned against one myself. I've watched footage of it. Obviously, it's been in pro play as well. And yeah, we're against Sona top. If you're completely in the dark and you're like, what? Yeah, this has been making the rounds for like the last week or so, Sona and Soraka top. And the idea of it, because of how messy top lane is at the moment and how little jungle pressure is in top lane and a few different reasons, basically a support who has good early scaling will basically be impossible for a normal top laner, a bruiser top laner, to kill. It's going to be very hard for me to actually kill this Sona. She's also running Ignite, so she's got that strength with Ignite. She's got the range advantage. She's got self-healing. So it's the idea of it's just to be very annoying. What I would say though with the actual team comp, as if you notice, the enemy team technically has three supports: Pyke, Sona, and Rakan. If we get to late game and we don't win this game, I'm going to be very surprised. But we do have a Yasuo. He's always a bit of a, you know, hit or miss. So we'll see how it goes. Bringing up the old loading though, while we kind of, you know, gold one, they do die quite a lot. They are a jungler, and yet have played, I guess, a little bit of Sona. You've got an auto-filled jungler who's a one-trick Pyke. Obviously, this guy's playing Pyke. And then you've got a bot lane, and they don't really play the lane much. Really good win rate over here on Ashe. Really good win rate on Soraka. Wow. Not terrible on Yasuo. That's actually good to see. And also pretty good silos. So again, looking at this, this should be a pretty easy win. But this episode specifically, yeah, we're going to focus in on this matchup. Like, how oppressive is it? Like, Twitch chat has already said to me, oh, you're going to enjoy this, Huzz. Like, you're just going to get bored. You're going to get poked out and you're not going to be able to do anything. But again, I've not experienced it myself. So I guess for the first time, I get to kind of see what it's about and lane against it. But yeah, let's get into it. We're playing Camille in the top lane. This is a triple reju bead game. It actually could be, you know. Yeah. I honestly think it is. Again, I don't rate that build when you're in normal matchups, but when you're against a cheese pick, it's pretty good. All right, welcome to the game. Today we're playing Camille against the... I don't even know. Do you call it a cheese pick? Because now, like, it's actually kind of meta in top lane. I don't know. We're running triple rejuves. Again, I don't like doing rejuves in a typical matchup. We explained this a little while ago, but when you're in a range matchup and you're playing a bruiser, all you've got to do... I know, by the way, I outscale this Sona in a 1v1. I know that. So all I've got to do is survive. Survive until I'm level 6, survive until I've probably got my Triforce, and I can kill her. Remember, she cannot get away when I have ult. So, and it is a support. So yeah, inevitable that I do kill her. I just have to make sure she doesn't get overly far ahead. Mischief Master, subbing for 12 months. Welcome to the year club, my dude. Massive appreciate it. Enjoy your new little lion sub logo. I got 22. This person's got 9 on EU. That might be the lowest I've ever seen on EU. Snap. That's really low. The luxury of mercy is one I cannot afford. Oh god, time to mute. I'm also kind of contemplating if I should have even gone Conqueror, by the way. Arcane Comet might have been a better idea against a Sona. Ugh. So, again, I know the general idea of it is that she just pokes you out. And we've said it for ages. When you're against a matchup that you're not supposed to win, I am not supposed to win this matchup in the early game. I know I'm not. So why would I try? I think that's what happens to a lot of players when they're against something stupid like a Sona or a Soraka top. They get frustrated. Oh, I'm against a cheese player. I'm going to try and kill it. And then they get killed. And then that makes it worse because then this pick gets stronger and you're getting weaker. And then the problem gets bigger and bigger and bigger. So just as much... I know it's really difficult to when you're against like this type of thing. just try to curtail like the annoyance of it as much as you can. And yeah. What'll be interesting to me is like, will I get ganked at all? Not sure. Oh my god! Huzzy and farming. I didn't ward, no, because I kind of remembered that Sona started. They started red, I think, because Sona was late to lane. So I don't think their jungler is this side of the map. If you're wondering why do I go down to river then, it's a fake out. So Sona makes pings missing. Now they think that I've probably got river warded, even though I don't. So she's hit the level. What the? Oh my god, this is a gank here. Let's go, dude! Let's go! That's good, that's good, that's good! She's got a terrible ward. Oh, this is gonna be easy! This is gonna be so easy! Let's go! She hasn't got teleport, remember, as well. Oh, let's go. That makes me feel good. So we're nearing triple her farm as well. So again, maybe just top laners haven't been doing the rejuve against it, the build against it, because like she's actually poked me quite a bit, by the way. Hasn't made an impact because of the rejuve beads. Yeah, that ward there killed her, by the way. I got her to half health in one combo, and I've got rejuve beads. Yeah. Okay. Why am I not letting the lane push to me? I find it boring. And I'm completely honest. I'm actually open about it here on my channel. If you're new, welcome. Yeah, I'm someone that doesn't play perfectly in League. I'm never going to. I'm never going to try. And I find freezing a wave one of the most boring things you can do in League. So I don't do it. I know that's kind of crazy, by the way, to some people. But yeah. I like showing that you can get to a decent rating by not playing perfectly. I'm not interested in playing perfectly. I ain't no robot. I'm here to have fun. I want the killer. How is this a hard matchup for any top laner, though? Like, I know I'm on a Smurf account and whatever, but, like, it's got no strength to it. It's a support pick. Well, again, this is my first time I'm ever laning against it, and I'm not impressed with it so far. Because, like, people will say, oh, she's not poking you enough. We've negated her poke by doing triple rejuve bead, so, like, that doesn't matter. And again, all I'm doing is just playing smart. I don't risk much. And you get rid of the pick. I'm not playing frustrated. I'm not letting the pick annoy me that I'm going for bad engages all the time. I'm playing smart. That's all you've got to do to beat a support top lane. Just play smart. Like, I'd say the one thing I will say, I imagine Soraka top lane may be a lot better than this. But like, I'm double farm. She's got no regen. Like, yeah. I don't know. Again, she does have Sona games. Maybe this is her first ever game of Sona top. I'll have a look. We'll do a bit of research. So she just played... She just played Soraka top, where she won. She played a Sona game top lane after that, and she went 2-9 and lost. Yeah, this player, she's just fully embraced the cheese, to try and get LP. Because they're a Warwick and Kha'Zix player. But since the Soraka meta and Soraka and Sona meta, that's all they've been playing. So it's just an example of that type of player that's like, oh, I'm going to do this strat for cheesy LP. Again, there's a reason why I don't do those strats, is because they're going to disappear within a few days of them coming out, you know? Alright. I could have killed her there. I mucked up. I should have pressed W during my E. That's just me not being a Camille player, though. Also, that was on the wrong button. I'm going to look to kill her, maybe, when she comes about here. I'm going to E, maybe. Because I know, I think Vi is actually not near here. I think Vi is actually bottom side of jungle. Oh, at least die with some dignity. I don't get it. Guys, if you're watching this on Twitch or YouTube, I don't get it. Like, I think, honestly, Camille might actually be pretty good against these picks in general, because the idea, again, you can't get away from a Camille when she ults you. So Camille actually could be a natural counter to these supporty picks, because she's got good engage, she's got her E, she's got true damage with her Q, and then she's got lockdown. So maybe I've just found the golden champion, the golden gem champion, to actually beat these support picks. Very possible. But I also don't see how I would struggle against this if I'm even playing like Darius. Oh, Sona's going bot lane. She is tilted. Kill it, kill it, kill it. At least get that kill. When you know you're dead, just do damage. The annoying thing is my team is kind of really sucking, it seems. Okay. They overstayed. All right, we get top lane tower. I guess, like, you know, I could go roam and help if I wanted to. Like, she's proper tilted. But the thing is, I might be even able to kill these people. Like, our Ashe is doing really bad with farm. Wait. Oh my god, I have Triforce. God, like, they are camping our bot lane, though. I will say that. I'm going to wait 20 gold. So yeah, Pyke was bot lane, who's their mid laner. They are just trying to really, really... And Sona's still bot lane. Yeah, they're just trying to really hurt our bot lane, I guess. If Sona comes back to top lane, she puts a toe in top lane, she's dead. Yeah, we got Triforce at 11 minutes. That's kind of insane. We've just been farming really... Again, I've had a free lane. I'm against a support. I'm sorry. Like, it's... I know maybe this is this game. I just haven't had a good example of it. Like, come on, guys. This Ashe. Wake up. Stupid. Ugh, no vision, you're playing a no mobility champion just casually walking when you've had vision of these guys being bot lane forever. Like, think when you play, it's not difficult. Really annoying. Oh. I misplayed that. Oh, well. I'm just going to, like, honestly think this game is just a stay top lane the whole game. Because, like, if they don't deal with me, I will literally get their inhibitor in the next 5 minutes. Like, I just will. So, like, yes, I've got... You don't need my teleport. There's two people top and I killed their jungler. What? Are these people... Why are they pinging me? Ooh, Pike's here. If he's here, do you think a bunch of people are here, though? Thought they were doing it. The only issue I've got to look for is, like, how many people they could send top lane to stop me. Because, like, Sona, I don't think this Sona's ever coming back to top lane. I will legitimately one-shot her if she comes here. Oh, Ashe, though. Again, we've got this Ashe that is just... Jesus. Astral185, welcome, dude. How's it going? 27 months. Holy moly. That's a long time. So Yasuo should be able to beat that Sona, you'd think. Oh. Okay. This is what my point was. They're just going to send three top against me. I honestly don't think we're going to win this game. Like, as bad pick as the Sona is, my team's playing really bad. So I actually don't think we're going to win. As bad as that sounds. Nice. Like, they're not pressuring that when no one is there. The Ashe just has no idea what's going on. Holy moly, dude. Come on. Did the Sona get baited by the YouTube videos? I mean, everybody that's playing has got baited by all of that stuff. Because there's no need to play it in solo queue. And maybe if you're a challenger, sure. But not in gold or platinum. Hell no. Just noticed I didn't fully level my Q the whole way. Huzzy derp. Can we make this work here? Arrow! Where's the Ashe arrow? There it is. I think that could have been quicker if I'm honest. Where do you think the Pike's gone? He's 8-0. Close. Again, the Pike, I don't know, unless he one-shots me, like, there's no way he beats me. I just don't know if he one-shots me at the moment or not. I don't think so. Get this Ashe out of my game. See, this is tilting. You've just got a team that you got a terrible Ashe who's basically AFK and inting, and then you've got people that are legit AFK. You guys are AFK. Holy moly, dude. Again, this is annoying because this is pointless. We crushed this, but like, the Ashe is just inting, and these guys are standing at the tower when I'm coming in. I was running the whole way. We had plenty of time. Like, oh, Camille's coming. They don't react. Insane. That was free. Oh. We should just go for the dragon. Good kill. Whoa. Wow, he didn't die. Ooh, hello. Yasuo might die. Whoa. We need to fight this. Easy peasy. This game is free if we just play it like average. Not even good. If we just play this game average. Shame that he got hooked. Where's he cannon? Alright, that's fine. Yes, I should back off. Game feels a bit ARAM-y, you know? I don't know why the enemy team is like... Well, maybe they feel like they need to end the game. That's possible. But, like, they are grouping heavily and constantly. So, like, their farm is getting hit pretty hard. Like, ours is terrible because, you know. But they could be extending their lead rather than shortening it. If she's stay... Oh, yeah, she's gonna. Nice. Free kill. Honestly, I think... Even against Soraka, Camille might be the answer. Because the whole point of them is to do pokey cheese and everything and heal. You can't get away. Camille's natural build is a pretty bursty... Oh, this Yasuo. Is a pretty bursty natural build. Oh, what are you guys doing? They're making this game impossible to win. Jesus Christ. This is insane. Just keep getting caught one by one by one by one. I have to back off. Stop making games harder for your team. Make games easier for your team. Crazy. This Ash is platinum. Platinum 4. And she's alone again, by the way, with no vision. Again. That's how Pyke has got so fed, by the way. Your team has destroyed a turret. We should just go keep going for every dragon. We get the soul. I actually want to fight the Pyke. If I can kill him, I think that would be a pretty good hit to the enemy team. Like, morale-wise as well for the Pyke. Oh, snap, I don't beat the Camille type thing, you know? This is simply my profession. Can you please be here? Like, ugh. If you're having a bad game, the least thing you can do is be in the right place for your team. That's the not difficult part. Alright, who do I actually want to go on, though? Pyke? sucks that I actually might have to go on a pike. That feels awful. Ashy. My Penta! Man, that would have been a Penta kill. Alright. This is easy. Just kill the AD carry and then they've legit got, like, nothing. Because, like, Pyke is an executor. So he generally needs, in a teamfight situation, he needs something to get everything low. And in this game, that's a Zaya. So kill the Zaya and they lose out basically on all of their damage that they actually need for the Pyke to work. And if I ult the Pyke, then that ruins his ult as well. Nice. Cool. Sweet. So yeah, we've had a pretty... I've got 4,000 gold. Had a free game here on Camille. So we've just been let to do anything I want because of the Sona pick. So that's nice. I'm going to go GA. Maybe I should have bought an elixir, but... yeah. I like Camille, by the way. Again, for someone that doesn't play any of this champion, or they, again, we have this Ashe, they have the Sona, pretty much. These two, and we have the Yasuo. Like, this pick, it's not even the pick, it's the player is so bad. Legitimately feels like they're inting. I legit, like, what? But it just feels like these players don't want to win. This is insane. It's absolutely insane. So I think Phantom would be better than Sterix, not on Camille, no. Oh, I just wish these people were just... like, they don't even have to do good things. Just don't do negative things. Like, the Ashe has played so bad this game. Really? What even happened to me, dude? Oh. God damn it. I'm now trying hard because I have to do stuff by myself. I'm going to be honest where my mind is right now. I really want to surrender this game. I'm not even, like, sad to say it. Like, I think the one thing, if we'd be completely honest, if I wasn't, let's say, a Smurf this game, this team would have got absolutely owned. Like... there's no question in my mind they would have got absolutely owned. Like, what is this positioning? Why? Why are you farming so deep? Like, this is insane. I don't get it. Like, and then you're following them in a 3v5. Like, what am I witnessing? That didn't go off. I can't win with these players. I cannot win with them. He's got 21 kills. Like, I just don't get it. You just take a free game. They've got a support top lane, and it's the Yasuo syndrome player and this Ashe. They just... again, it's very hard not to get annoyed with these games. Like, I'm human, obviously. She's not toxic at all. This is the point, is like, these people are so soft that they think someone's saying that is toxic. Like, if you think the Soraka is toxic, don't play solo queue. You're too soft. Holy moly. It's insane. Absolutely insane. The frustration with these players is completely understandable. It's like they're trying to lose. Insane. Oh, look, who's mid lane alone? Oh, they're not dead. Oh my god, they didn't die. It's a miracle. We should get priority over the pit. This is actually really good for us. They won't have Pike up for Elder Dragon. Why am I not hard splitting? Because I don't trust my team. Never split push when you don't trust your team. Arguably, we should not do it and risk a steal. Arguably, we should just fight them, you know? Now do it. There we go. That's better. I didn't really want to commit to doing the whole dragon because all you needed was her to steal. I did, by the way, Oh, I hit him. I think I got him. Yeah, nice. Good arrow. Like, what the hell? This is such a free game. This is why it's so frustrating, is when you know a game's for free and then you have people that just are randomly positioning to die all the time. It's like, dude. Why? Just don't make games harder when you want to climb. It don't make any sense. The one thing that, if it's okay, by the way, to have bad games. I'm never going to say you can't have a bad game. Everybody will have them. The best players in the world have bad games. The one thing that you shouldn't do, though, is make negative things happen in your games. Like, avoidable things. It's very avoidable to not be alone as an AD carry, right? In mid lane, by yourself as an Ashe with no mobility. You can stop that, like, of all things that you can do. You don't have to be alone as an Ashe in bot lane at 25 minutes. You can fix those things. Do that. But we won the game. Again, that game, honestly, I didn't even care if we won or lost it. It was a free win, but those teammates were really frustrating me. I'm giving it to the Soraka. Because she actually played the best out of all of them. Holy moly, dude. So we gained 30. We go 18-4-7, 219 farm. We had to carry quite hard that game. And then damage-wise, we do... Yeah, that pretty much summarizes that game, I think. We do more than double anybody, so the closest was the Ashe at 15.5. We do basically 35,000, so more than double anybody on our team. Again, just the biggest thing that I'll say with solo queue is just don't make games harder for yourself. The Ashe made this game really difficult by her positioning. The Yasuo made this game really difficult by his positioning. Don't do that. You can fix your own positioning. Like, that's an easy thing to do. But that's going to be it. If you did enjoy, throw a like on it. Again, frustration's going to happen. It's always going to happen. Like, the one thing I will say, slight annoyance here as a YouTuber, guarantee the person that comments, "Huzz, I don't like when you're frustrated." So, guarantee you're the person that gets more frustrated than me and actually types things to your team. Guarantee it. Anyway, that's going to be it. If you guys did enjoy, throw a like on it. Throw a subscribe, and I'll see you guys next time.